The Tanakh is the Hebrew Bible. It is made up of three sections: the Torah, which are the five books of Moses, the Nevi'im, the prophets, and the Ketuvim, the writings. The Tanakh was canonized in approximately 500 BCE by the Anshei Knesset Hagadola, men of the Great Assembly. The men of the Great Assembly came together and expanded the Sanhedrin, which is the Jewish Supreme Court, from 70 members to 120 in an attempt to strengthen Judaism. The Tanakh was not originally broken into chapters and verses. The idea of chapters and verses, as well as the breaking apart of Samuel, Kings, and Chronicles, is a leftover from Christians in the 13th century. Before the study of Torah, a blessing is said in which the person thanks God for giving the Jews Torah. There have been many rabbis who have written commentaries on the Torah. Any complete study of the Torah needs to include some commentary from these sages. The Torah, the five books of Moses, is made up of five books that were given to Moses directly from God shortly after the Exodus from Egypt, around 1230 BCE. The written Torah, the five books of Moses, and the oral Torah, the Mishnah, were handed down through the successive generations from the time of Moses. God gave Torah to Moses, who gave it to Joshua, who gave it to the elders, who gave it to the prophets, who gave it to the men of the great assembly, who gave it to the Pharisees, who gave it to the rabbis. The Torah includes the creation of the earth and the first humans, the great flood and the covenant with the Gentiles, the enslavement of the Hebrews in Egypt, the Exodus, the giving of the Torah, the renewal of the covenant given to Abraham, the establishment of the festivals, the 40 years of wandering through the desert, the tabernacle, ark, and priestly duties, and the death of Moses. The Torah is broken down into parts called parshiot. Each parsha is usually named after one of the first words of that section of the Torah. The parsha is divided into seven sections. Each section is called an aliyah, since a person goes up to make a blessing on the Torah reading. There's also an additional eighth section called the maftir. The maftir is either a repetition of the last few verses of the seventh aliyah or a special reading on special Shabbats. The Torah is read every year according to a Torah reading schedule. The Babylonian Jewish community divided the Torah into 54 portions, which allow for the complete reading of the Torah in 1 year. The Egyptian and Palestinian Jewish communities divided the Torah into 154 portions, allowing for the complete reading of the Torah in 3 year cycles, called the triennial cycle. The five books of the Torah were written by Moses and include Bereshit, which is known as Genesis and means in the beginning, Shemot, which is known as Exodus, which means names, Vayikra, which is known by its Leviticus, which means and he called, Bamidbar, Numbers, which means in the wilderness, and Devarim, Deuteronomy, which means words. The Nevi'im, the prophets, includes the time period from the death of Moses through the Babylonian exile, approximately 1200 BCE to 587 BCE, and contains 19 books. The Nevi'im includes the Hebrews entering the land of Israel, the conquest of Jericho, the conquest of the land of Israel and the division among the tribes, the judicial system, the era of Saul and David, Solomon's wisdom and the construction of the first temple, the kings of Israel, prophecy, messianic prophecies, and the Babylonian exile. The Nevi'im books include Yehoshua, Joshua, which means God is salvation, and was written by Joshua and Phinehas. Shoftim, which is Judges, was written by Samuel. Shmuel, Samuel, which means his name is God, was written by Samuel, Gad, and Nathan. Melachim, Kings, was written by Jeremiah. Yeshayahu, Isaiah, which means God is salvation, was written by the school of King of Hezekiah. Yirmiyahu, Jeremiah, which means God will uplift, was written by Jeremiah and the men of the great assembly. Yechizkiel, Ezekiel, which means God will strengthen, was written by the men of the great assembly. The remaining 12 books of the Nevi'im were written by the men of the great assembly. Hosea, which means salvation, Yoel, Joel, which means God is willing, Amos, which means to be burdened or troubled, Obadiah, which means servant of God, Jonah, which means dove, Micah, which means who is like God, Nahum, which means comfort, Habakkuk, which means to wrestle, Zephaniah, which means hidden by God, Haggai, which means festive, Zechariah, which means memory, and Malachi, which means my servant. The Ketuvim, or writings, includes the period after the return from the Babylonian exile, in approximately the 6th century BCE, and contains 12 books. The Ketuvim is made up of various writings that do not have an overall theme. This section of the Tanakh includes poems and songs, the stories of Job, Ruth, and Esther, the writings and prophecies of Daniel, and the history of the kings of Israel. Ketuvim include Tehillim, Psalms, which means praises, and was written by David, Adam, Abraham, and Moses. Mishle, Proverbs, which means wisdoms, was written by Solomon. Iyov, Job, which means hatred or oppressed, was written by Moses. Shir HaShirim, Song of Songs, was written by Solomon. Rut, or Ruth, which means friendship, was written by Samuel. Echa, Lamentations, which means alas, was written by Jeremiah. Kohelet, Ecclesiastes, which means assembly of people, was written by Solomon. Esther, which means star, was written by the men of the great assembly. Daniel, which means God is my judge, was written by the men of the great assembly. Ezra, which means help, was written by Ezra. Nehemiah, which means comforted by the Lord, was written by Ezra. Divrei Hayamim, Chronicles, which means words of the days, was written by Ezra and Nehemiah. The Tanakh contains the laws, history, prophecies, and writings of the Jewish people. The Tanakh, however, is a religious text that is for everyone. I encourage all of you to study the Tanakh. An English translation with commentary from Rashi is available through the Chabad website, www.chabad.org, chabad.org, and is located on their library page listed under Classic Jewish Text. A Hebrew version with English translations is available through Machon Mamre. That's www.mechon-mamre.org/index.htm.
This has been a Punk Torah production. Thank you for watching.